I think she'll tell us what she's asking us to do.
May I approach to show the...
Yes. Make sure you don't let the papers hit this thing here.
This is the PowerPoint, so that's the last page. Ms. Lowe is teaching a parent in competition with other individuals on behalf of the FBI. And when she's teaching them, she's referring to studies. She's referring to studies, it's my understanding of Mr. Ashton. He is interpreting the study, and she's interpreting the study as not exculpatory. But we have the right to interpret it ourselves, but we didn't be.
Okay, let me ask you this. And you can answer this during your cross-examination. What I'm trying to ascertain is whether or not she's utilizing this study in any opinion that she is offering here today.
Okay, that's the first threshold. It can either be yes or no. Then the next question, if it's no, is whether or not anything in this study may be exculpatory. If it is, it may be. But the question comes up is the FBI is probably not the only individual, or may be, that has conducted similar studies. And the question comes in, if there are hundreds of studies out there, whose responsibility it is, and do we wait on all those studies? So let's get that threshold question answered. And if it is, then you may have a point. If it is not, you still may have a point. But let's cross the initial threshold, whether or not she's utilizing this study in formulating her opinion, which she's testifying here today. And then the second part, if she's not, whether or not you may be entitled to this and whether or not it's exculpatory evidence. It is very difficult for me to determine whether or not it is when I don't know what's in it. And maybe during your cross-examination, which he may not go into this study, I will grant you the latitude to question her about this study and its relationship to what she's testifying here today. And then we can make a determination whether or not this manuscript or study has any relationship to the issue which she's testifying to. Because I think this PowerPoint is something that she utilizes to teach the subject on. And it's not something that she's based her opinion that she's testifying to here today.
No, she's not based on PowerPoint.
The problem with that and okay. The potential way to resolve that is we don't know, nobody knows what that research shows. The call was made, I believe, because the FBI may have had some concern. Well, Mr. Baez, if you can bring forth exactly the wording.
Mr. Baez?
I think it's fairly consistent with what she's testified to here today, that there are some of the samples that indicate early stages of decomposition. Now, whether Mr. Ashton considers that exculpatory or inculpatory, I think that's our call to make, and certainly that's why I think we're here.
Just so to be clear, I'm not disagreeing that counsel may be entitled to some of this information, but I'm still not clear on what counsel is asking the court to do now. That would be helpful.
All right.
Thank you.
If we could be limited to the position of Ms. Lowe after receiving the material, or I'll just back to court prior to its ruling,
okay. Well, let's do this. Let's finish what she's doing here today. I think you may have a point in trying to take a deposition about this. You may or should have a right to determine whether or not under Brady versus Maryland this is exculpatory evidence. If it is exculpatory evidence and they quote, hiding the ball, which they don't appear to be hiding the ball, but you don't have it, then we all know what the penalty is for that.
That's no problem. I agree that there's things that need to be, that should be provided.
Yeah.
I do want to make it clear that the FBI came forward on their own to volunteer this as possible.
But it's two separate issues. Let's take care of this, and then we're moving into the second phase, but you do have a point. Give it to the clerk. The clerk will make a copy of just the portion that you've showed me, and she will return, show the page that you want a copy of, and it will be defense number, whatever it is, for identification for purposes of an exhibit.
May I have the whole thing, or just a simple PowerPoint with another pages that I'm going to ask for
questions on?
Okay. I think we can have that marked as for identification, but the only one that's doing this is the last page.
Correct. Well, I like the whole thing.
Well, let's just mark it. We'll mark it as a composite, and we will refer to it. Once the clerk has it marked, she will refer to on the record that portion of the composite that you were talking about and which has been the subject of some questions and discussions.
I have no further questions.
Yes, ma'am.
Good morning. Can you hear me?
Good morning. Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Hi, my name is Dorothy Sims, and I just have a few questions for you with regard to your direct testimony. I believe you said that banding is actually less common than the brush-like effect on a hair evidencing decomposition. Is that correct?
That's what was referred to in the Lynch and Prelau paper.
And in this case, there was no brush-like appearance. Is that correct?
On the Q12 hair, that's correct.
Okay. And my understanding is Q12 is actually what is known as debris. That what we're referring to is Q12-1.
This has been kind of confusing. When it came into the laboratory, it was marked as debris, was given the designation Q12. The contents were examined, and when the hair moved to mitochondrial DNA, that became Q12.1 to track its movement to another unit.
Okay.
So Q12 and Q12.1 are essentially the same thing. It was just given another designation when it moved to mitochondrial DNA.
All right. And hairs evidencing apparent decomposition have not been used to determine time of death, have they, by you?
No, sir. No, ma'am.
Okay. And I believe, as I understand it, in this case, the most you can say is that Q12 or Q12.1 evidences apparent characteristics of decomposition. Is that correct?
That was stated in my report. The characteristics present are consistent with postmortem root banding. The reason that I added the apparent decomposition was to signify that that's not the only possible scenario, is in that this hair came from a dead body. I'm not aware of anything else that is imparted these characteristics, but I can't rule out the possibility.
All right, and as I understand it, you got a root portion, but not the entire root. Is that correct?
No, ma'am.
You had the entire root?
Yes, I believe so.
Are you sure?
It was an antigen hair. There was root material above the postmortem root banding, as well as the remainder of the shaft.
All right, but my question is, you did not have the entire root, did you? You had a root portion?
No, ma'am, to my knowledge.
If I may, Your Honor, the issue for this hearing is the general acceptance of the concept, not a general cross-examination. This is not relevant to the issue presented in the motion.
Well, in order to reply, Your Honor, I need to know, A, if the procedure is new, if the methodology was correct, and if the conclusions were reached based on sufficient data. This isn't just a Frye hearing. There's also other areas that we covered in our motion, such as relevance, prejudice, et cetera, and I need to inquire not only for the Frye, but for those other areas of the motion.
Your Honor, this witness was subject to extensive deposition. I think counsel is now trying to learn.
Objection sustained. I thought we were doing a Frye hearing. That's the purpose.
Well, Your Honor, for the record, her deposition, which I believe is evidence at this point.
If you all have submitted it to the court file, it's not any evidence, it is.
Okay.
It should be in the court file.
All right. Her deposition reveals something different. Her deposition reveals a root portion of intelligent, and that's the reason I asked the question, because she indicated the whole root.
The purpose of the hearing is to determine whether or not this is new or novel. If it's new or novel, whether or not it is generally accepted in the scientific community. That's the purpose of the hearing today. Her testimony at trial is always subject to objection, dealing with relevancy or materiality, and those other things that you're bringing up goes to the weight that some juror or juror may assign to whatever she testifies, but the purpose is a Frye hearing, and that's what we've said. Objection sustained.
All right. Your testimony, as I understand it, was apparent decomposition. Your testimony was not that you concluded post-mortem root banding in this hair. Is that correct?
The characteristics present in this hair were consistent with postmortem root banding, which I reported as apparent decomposition.
The root banding that you're talking about is a darkening area of a hair. Is that correct?
A darkened portion adjacent to the tip of the root.
And the photograph that was taken of the hair shows darkened areas in places other than the area in which
objection. You... Objection. It doesn't go to the Frye issue.
Well, Your Honor, this just isn't the Frye issue. It's also whether or not it's probative or relevant. And if there's... And I do believe it also does go to the Frye issue, because if the hair has darkened portions and the testimony is that means apparent decomposition, but there's other areas in the hair that are also dark, then I think it may be somewhat confusing and unscientific.
Objection sustained. Again, we're drifting away from issues dealing with Frye.
Okay. The catagen phase that you discussed earlier is the approximately, what, 2% of the hairs that are involved. You've got catagen, telogen, and anagen. Is that correct?
Yeah, so those are the three phases, yes.
All right. Now, at your deposition, you were asked about a PowerPoint presentation that you were using when you were teaching postmortem root banding, correct?
Yes, ma'am.
All right. And we received from the state what appears to be a 7-page PowerPoint presentation that was entitled Postmortem Root Banding. Is that your PowerPoint presentation?
It's a PowerPoint presentation that I put together for today's hearing.
And in the PowerPoint presentation, the example that you used for postmortem root band actually is much closer to the root than the darkened area in Q12.
Objection, relevance,
response.
Your Honor, if I'm allowed to cross-examine her as to the basis that of her conclusions, I have to be, in terms of our motion, I have to be able to show that the data upon which she relies is scientific and...
Objection overruled. You may continue.
I'm sorry, go ahead.